guys. I'm going, okay, let's see. I am going to show you how I get my paints from these big jars and I put them into the smaller squirt bottles. I like to buy them in the big containers. Number one, it's a better deal, and it's a lot of paint. So, and I have two studios, so it makes it more sense to split it up. So far, I've made a mess, as you can see, with the red. So let's give it a try, see if I can do better with this ultramarine blue. Let's see, get the top off. Look at this color, it's absolutely wonderful. And I am going to squish my container and very slowly start pouring. I like having it in a squirt bottle because it's just easy to just up and grab when I need some paint instead of having to screw around with opening up a jar. Now what I'm going to do with that extra bit that's sitting on the edge, I have a palette, and I'm going to scoop it off because once I'm done doing this, I'm going to do a painting using three colors as promised. All right, let's wipe this off here. Always clean the edges of your jar off. Otherwise, the cap just sticks to it. All right. We have that, and then wipe off this. I am covered in paint. All right, that's two down. And let's see, let's go with some Indian yellow next. Yeah, see, this is what happens when you don't. When you don't clean the top, obviously. I didn't clean it last time. There you go. So you'll see. When I open it, okay. Oh boy, did I ever mess up. Okay, look at this. You see that? That's what can happen. And it works like glue. So save yourself the hassle and just give it a wipe every time you use it. I don't know how I managed to not do that. One of those days, I guess. All right. Indian yellow, here we go. I don't know why they call it Indian yellow. All right. Let's move it. I'm going to try a different pouring technique here. It's a little bit lumpy. I can see some lumps going in there. All right. Let it do its thing, and then we're going to scoop the rest of that paint that's left. The Indian yellow has more of a slight orange cast, and let me save my paper towel. Okay, we'll go like this, give it a good wipe. And sometimes you have to take your nail and just peel the stuff that's around the corner. Okay, see this? You want to get all that stuff. All this. Just peel it with your nail. Okay, there we go. So that's not going to stick now. Fingers crossed. All right, we got those. Make a mess around here. Okay, next. Let's see. Don't need black. How about some cerulean blue? Let's make one. Oh, here's another one I messed up. Let's see what kind of mess I got going on here. Oh, not too bad. Not quite as bad as the last one. And I'm going to peel that crud off there. Alrighty, now we'll pour this baby in. Okay. Put the top on. Put the top on the yellow. And clean off the top of this cerulean blue after I get some paint off there. Yeah, nobody likes to waste their paint. Get it cleaned up. Now wipe your top off. Well, you'll have the same problems I had. And that goes for your small jars too. Make sure they're nice and clean. This acrylic is hard as a rock when it dries. Okay. And put your cap back on good and tight and keep them upright. I think that's what my problem has been, because I have my studio at my gallery and I have a studio at home, and I'm constantly transporting my paints back and forth, so that's why the bottles makes it much easier. Okay, so there's quinacridone red, my first color I put in a bottle. This one here is quinacridone magenta. So let's take a look at the red. This one, not too bad. A little bit. Let's go here. Now, I don't know if you can see how creamy this is, but it's just beautiful paint. It's Nova Colors, and I've been using them for a couple of years now, and that's thanks to Betty Franks. She turned me onto them. And I started off by just going into Nova Paints and buying Betty's bundle. It's a great set of paints. And I've been addicted ever since. They're wonderful. And they're nice colors, easy to use. And I don't have to mess with tubes. Okay, so let's get this paint off here and put it on the palette. Might as well use it. There we go. Okay. Now, this is my first day of using my new camera. I bought a Canon M50 used. And it came with a boom mic. So hopefully everything is working. I have been shooting all my videos with my iPhone for the last 6 months, and I needed something with better quality and easier to use. So we'll see how this turns out. Wish me luck. Okay, that's quinacridone red. Hopefully I'm saying it properly. All right, so we've got colors on our palette. And so we're ready to rock and roll. I am going to label all my containers so I don't forget what is in them. So good idea to do that. Now check out my other videos. Oh, let me see. Yeah, that way. Gotta get used to this.